Matt, the Mortgage Guy here. In today's video, I want to talk about why we need to collect more documents once we submit your loan to the underwriter. Before I jump into it, if you like straightforward videos and content from a mortgage broker who's in it all day, every day, thousands of clients, thousands of conversations, all kinds of different scenarios I run into. I give my honest feedback and tell you the honest truth about how the mortgage world works, what my thoughts are on real estate through the dozens of conversations I have every single week with real estate agents. Like, comment, subscribe, do all that stuff for the YouTube algorithm, if you would please. So this video is my best effort to answer the question so many of you have, where we've collected all the documents up front, and we've asked you for tax returns in some cases. We've asked you for 2 months of bank statements. We've asked you for 30 days of pay stubs. We've asked you for everything we need to do a really thorough pre-approval. And anybody who's worked with us knows we are going to do our best to turn over every stone. No stone unturned, whatever the heck the saying is, right? We want to make sure that we pre-approve you and say you're good to buy a $600,000 house with 10% down. That pre-approval means something, right? And we don't have fallout because of that reason, because we're going to do, you know, you justice. We're going to do our due diligence and make sure that we've got a full file that we know is going to be able to make it to the finish line. With that said, we've been getting a lot of feedback. We've been getting a lot of questions. Hey, Matt. Hey, Matt's team. I gave you everything. You told me that I was good to go. Then I got in the contract and you submitted my file. Now the underwriter wants four more things. Why is that? Now, I want to answer that question as honestly as I can. You're almost always going to have conditions from underwriting, no matter how clean of a file you submit, no matter how perfect you are about providing us everything we ask for. Let's talk about a couple different things they're going to ask for. You might have, in October, when we pre-approved you, given us August and September bank statements. Now you're in contract in November. We're closing in December. Underwriters are going to ask for updated bank statements. You might have provided, as a self-employed borrower, tax returns. The underwriter's inevitably going to ask for a profit and loss statement, maybe a letter explanation about a prior address. All kinds of different things can and will come up. It shouldn't be any reason to be worried or be upset, because it's very common. In the thousands of files that we submit, it's almost always conditions needed, right? So you'll get a conditional approval. And we're used to it because we see it day in and day out. But for clients, they may or may not be used to it. I'm here to tell you, don't worry about it. If you submit a loan and the loan officer comes back to you and says, congratulations, we've got a conditional approval. We need these three things, these five things, these seven things, whatever it is, right? Simple of letter explanation about something that showed up on your credit. A simple letter of explanation about a past address and how that relates to you. All these things, the underwriter's just trying to make sure they dot all I's, they cross all T's. More often than not, those simple letters of explanation, another month of bank statements, a profit and loss if you're self-employed, these things aren't hard to get. And these things aren't anything that's going to derail the deal or you know, make it so it doesn't cross the finish line. But be prepared for underwriters to ask for that stuff, because it happens. Every single file, pretty much. And so you're going to hopefully work with a lender who's going to gather most everything up front. So you've got an airtight pre-approval, a loan that's going to close. Then, whether it's 2 weeks later, 4 weeks later, 3 months later, when you get into contract and the loan gets submitted, inevitably, even if we collect a few things before we submit, you know, it's been 3 months since you've been pre-approved. Hey, we got to gather the last couple months of bank statements, 30 days of pay stubs, we're still going to submit it. And they're going to have a question about an address, a question about something that came up on credit, you know, some dates with employment, you know, how you filled out the application. They want some clarification. Whatever the case is, don't worry about it. It's common. We're still getting the loan to the finish line. Hopefully that was helpful. If you have questions for us, if we can help you in any way, whether it's a purchase, whether it's a refinance, or if it's just some good advice on your specific scenario, reach out to us, greatmortgagebroker.com, fill out the form, where you're at, how we can help, whether you're looking to purchase or refinance. We'll get in touch with you very soon. Until next time, we gonna see.